Short Handy Hints video, we're going to show how to update the target settings on A&D's popular waterproof traffic light scale, the SJ-WP. This model was updated about 18 months ago. The time of this video is February 2018, and the setting procedure changed very slightly. So what I'm going to show you now is the latest model. It's easy to visually distinguish because at the time of changing the design, this Perspex guarding was changed to a light blue color. So any models with a light blue Perspex, this is how you change the target settings. So the keys on this scale, for those that are unfamiliar, it's actually a touch type capacitive key. So there's no clicky buttons or soft buttons that can be damaged. So to actually enable or use the buttons, you press and hold them for a second or two, and that amount of time can be changed in the function settings of the scale. So if we want to go in and change the settings for the traffic lights, at the moment this scale is going to only use three lights. We'll have a red light here, a green light here, and a red light here, which is the most common setup. You can configure it to use all five lights if you prefer, with orange lights either side of green. So to get into the target settings, we touch the tear key, and while touching that, we turn on the scale. You'll see the software version come up, and while that's displayed, press and hold the units key, and then the low value setting screen comes up. So you can see at the moment there's six digits on the screen. This particular scale is a 15 kilo version. We have it set up in our non-weights and measures mode, which means it actually measures up to 15 kilos by 1 gram, so 15,000 grams. In the case of changing the values, let's say we want to set this with a lower limit of 1 kilo and an upper limit of 1.5 kilos. You'll see underneath each button there's a secondary symbol, which is what we're going to refer to now. So we want the 1000s digit to start flashing. We press the right hand arrow, the units key, and then press it again until the 1000s digit is flashing. Then we increment it to the value you want, in this case 1000. Then we can move on to the next set point. If you happen to overshoot, then just keep pressing it or tapping the key several times until it comes back to the value you want. So that's our low value, 1000 grams. Let's make it 1010 just to be interesting. So we go across, increment to 1010. Then when you're happy with that, you press the tear key. Now it goes to the high value setting. Again, we've got all zeros on the screen. If we want to go to 2000 grams as our high value, we go across until the thousands column is flashing, go up twice. That's now 2000 grams. Hit enter, it says end, and it'll come back on in weighing mode. And you'll see when I put some weight on the scale after it comes up with zero, basically, the traffic lights will respond accordingly to the set points that we set before. So the key here is you want people packing manually to be not just over the minimum weight, but you don't want them to give away too much product. So you want them to be under your upper tolerance. That way you can manage your giveaway when you're packing manually. And this scale, of course, only runs on batteries, but one set of batteries will last up to 2 years or 5,000 hours of actual use if you use some good quality alkaline batteries. And it is, of course, completely submersible as a scale. Thanks for watching. If you've got any questions or need assistance, contact A&D directly or your local A&D authorized dealer. Thanks again.